Hey guys, Cash here. Welcome back to your Thursday flow. So today's flow, we're sticking with our challenging workouts this summer. So today's flow is called fire and perspire. So you will build up a sweat, you're gonna work your legs, work your core, work your arms, and feel amazing after this practice. We're gonna start today at the beginning of the mat. So just start standing nice and tall. Relax your shoulders down, relax the jaw. Feel free to soften or close your eyes. And then start to find your center. So maybe shift forward, coming into the toes, shift back, taking weight into your heels. And maybe do that for a couple of rounds until you find your nice, happy center, balancing in between the balls of your feet and your heels. Once you've found that center, that space that's right for you, begin to breathe. Take a nice deep breath in, deep breath out. Again, deep breath in, deep breath out. As you breathe in, feel rooted down through your feet. So the energy, your breath is traveling up through your heels, going up into the calves, the quads, the hamstrings, moving up to the core, lifting the chest, still inhaling all the way to the crown of the head. As you exhale, release, keeping length, but letting go of tension. Trying to create space and let go of what we do not need. Keep breathing here. With your next breath, inhale, take the arms up above the head, gaze up, palms touch. As you exhale, part fold. Inhale, lift up halfway, flat back, take your hands to your shins, gaze down. Chin is tucked in towards the chest. Exhale, fold. Inhale, press down through your heels, rooting down, reach the arms up, up above the head. Exhale, take the hands to the heart. We're gonna do that one more time, picking up speed. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, part fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, hands to shins. Exhale, fold. Inhale, press down through your feet, travel all the way up, reaching the arms up. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, take the arms up. Exhale, part fold. This time, take a bend in your knees. Let your fingertips touch the mat. Step all the way back into plank. From plank, shift your hips forward. I'm sorry, roll forward on your toes, and then drop your knees down to the mat. From here, drop your chest in between your thumbs and drop your chin. 8-point pose, so your hips are high. Inhale, untuck the toes, lift the chest through. Exhale, lower down. Tuck the toes under. Inhale your way to plank. From plank, knees come wide, big toes touch, hips go back. Child's pose. One deep breath in. Deep breath out. Inhale, slowly come up to table. From table, tuck your toes under. Lift the hips up and back. Downward facing dog. First downward dog of today's class. Get comfy here. Maybe pedaling out your feet. Shaking your head from side to side, maybe moving your hips from side to side, just taking little movements that help your body adjust into the pose. And then once you've found whatever you need here, find stillness, holding downward dog. We'll take 3 breaths in through the nose and 3 breaths out. So fingers are pressing wide. Chest is pressing back for the thighs, head is heavy, gaze is towards the legs. Take one deep breath in, deep breath out. From here, slowly begin to step your feet up to the top of the mat, fold at the top of the mat. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, press the heels down, reach the arms up all the way to the sky. As you exhale, take your hands to your heart. All right, let's build that heat. Inhale, lift the arms up. As you exhale, sit back into a chair. So one thing I want you to notice that a chair pose in yoga is a little bit different from your typical squat. So you want to make sure that your knee's in line with the ankle and that you're putting all of your weight in towards the heels. Pull your belly button back towards the spine, but lift your chest up. So you're not trying to get low here as much as you are trying to activate the glutes. So from this position, you should really feel your work right here in the glutes firing up. We're gonna take 5 breaths here. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Keep trying to drop the shoulders down, really plugging the shoulders onto the back. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Weight is in towards the heels, glutes are activated here. One more deep breath in, deep breath out. Nice work. Inhale, stand. Exhale, sit back into that chair. We've got 5. Inhale, exhale. Nice work. Inhale, really feeling your glutes. Exhale. 2 more times. Inhale, exhale. Last one. Inhale, exhale. So we're holding once again. Belly button's pulling back towards the spine. Chest is lifted. Again, we're not trying to go low as much as we are trying to keep the knee right above the ankle. Pressing weight down into the heels, feeling that heat. Take a breath in. Exhale, fold. Ha. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. Step all the way back into plank. Feel free to lower down how we did the first time, knees, chest, and chin. Or to lower down chaturanga halfway, bottom of the push-up. Untuck your toes, lift your chest. Inhale. Exhale, take the hips up and back, downward facing dog. Hips are nice and high, chest pressing back for the thighs. Inhale, sweep the right leg up to the sky. As you exhale, step your right foot to the top of the mat. Take a tiny step forward with your left foot. Take your left heel down to the mat. Left toes will be at a 45 degree angle. Warrior one. Inhale, reach the arms up above the head. So for your warrior one, make sure your hips are square facing the front edge of the mat. Right knee is bent, knees in line with the ankle. Back heel, your left heel is pressing to the mat with the toes at a 45 degree angle. From here, reach the arms up. Breathe. So there's somewhat of a challenge in this pose, but there's also some stillness here. Take a deep breath in, deep breath out. Again, deep breath in, deep breath out. Let's do one more here together. Deep breath in, deep breath out. From here, inhale, lift the fingertips straight up. As you exhale, hinge forward. Take all the weight into your right foot. Back should be flat, so your arms are parallel with the ground. Bring weight into your right foot. Inhale, reach long through your fingertips. Exhale, crunch, knee, left knee in the chest. Inhale, step the left leg back. Exhale, left knee in the chest. Inhale, left leg back. Exhale, knee in the chest. We've got 5. 4. Make sure to breathe. 3. Should feel that right glute burning too. Last one. Nice. Step all the way back. Inhale, reach the arms up. We're in crescent pose, so back toes are tucked under. As you exhale, take your fingertips down to the mat. Drop the left knee, untuck the left toes. Nice work. From here, begin to inhale, extend the right leg, exhale, bend. Inhale, extend. Exhale, bend. Wave to my neighbor. One more round, inhale, extend. Exhale, bend. Nice work. From here, begin to tuck the left toes under, come off of the left knee. Take a giant step up to the top of the mat with your left foot, fold. Inhale, halfway lift up, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise to stand, reach the arms up, palms touch, gaze up. to the heart. Take a breath in. Take a breath out of the mouth. One more sighing breath. In through the nose. Out of the mouth. Notice how your right leg feels compared to your left leg. There's some work that's happening there. Take one more breath in. One more breath out. All right, let's get back to work. Inhale, take the arms up. As you exhale, sit back into your chair. All right, so already take a moment. Notice your form here in your chair. Heel weight is down into the heel. So I don't want to see you up on your toes. Keep the heels down. Knees are in line with the ankle. So knees are not coming past the toes. Knees are right above the ankle. Belly button is pulling back towards the spine. Chest is lifting up. Shoulders are dropping down onto your back. Spread the fingers wide. Find your breath. Feel that shakiness that's starting to enter in. Breathe. We've got five breaths. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Keep moving. Keep, well, not moving. We're still static, but keep breathing. Nice. Take one more huge breath in. Huge breath out. Inhale, lift the arms up. Exhale, sit it back. Inhale up. Exhale, sit back. Keep working. Inhale. Exhale. We've got five more. Four. Three. Really working those glutes. Two. Squeeze the core at the top. Last one. Inhale up. Exhale, sit back. Chair. We're holding here for three. You've got this. Two. Stay with me. One. Fold. Nice work. Shake out the head. And inhale, half lift. Find that flat back. Exhale, fold. Deep bend in your knees. Fingertips touch the mat. Step back into plank. Take a deep breath in plank. And then exhale, lower down. Knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Bottom of the push-up. Untuck the toes. Inhale, lift the chest. As you exhale, take your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Three breaths here. Remember, child's pose is always available to you at any point if you need in our practice. No matter where you're at, breathe, finding length through the spine. Nice. Inhale, lift the left leg up. As you exhale, step your left foot to the top of the mat. Warrior two, left side. Tiny step forward with your right foot. Take your right heel down to the mat. Right toes will be at a 45 degree angle. Inhale, lift the arms up. From here, make sure that your hips are square with the front edge of the mat and you're bending into that left knee. Left knee should be in line with the ankle. Reach the arms up, spread the fingers wide, chest is nice and high. Breathe, deep breath in. Deep breath out. Keep squeezing that core, pulling belly button back towards the spine. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. You've got this. One more. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. All right, we've got our reaches here. Inhale, reach the fingertips up. As you exhale, send the chest forward. Back is flat. Your back should be parallel with the ground. Arms should be parallel with the ground. Inhale, you should already feel your left glute doing a ton of work. All of your weight is into your left foot and your left knee is still in line with the ankle. Knees are not coming past the toe. Inhale as you find length, reach. Exhale, knee in the chest. Inhale, reach long. Exhale, knee in the chest. Inhale. Exhale, you've got this. Five, keep breathing. Four, three, two, last one. Hold it in, get a nice squeeze. Take the leg back, inhale, reach the arms up, crescent lunge. So this time, right toes are tucked under, right heel is off the mat. Inhale, reach the arms up, As you exhale, part the arms, fingertips come down. Drop your right knee, untuck the right toes. Begin to inhale, extend the left leg. Exhale, bend. Inhale, extend. Exhale, bend, moving with your breath. We'll take a few rounds here. Nice. And then from here, we'll tuck the right toes under and then come off of the right knee. Take your left hand to the inside of your left foot. Walk your hands over to the right side. Wide leg forward fold. Relax the head, the neck, the shoulders. This should feel really, really good for your glutes, the backs of the legs. If you want to come down to your forearms, you can, if that feels good. Maybe shake your head yes, nod your head no. Slowly press your way back up to your palms, and then we'll take Skandasana to either side. So begin to bend into your right knee, extend the left leg, and then bend into your left knee, extend the right leg. So we're just moving from side to side here, loosening up the hips and stretching out the inner thighs. Nice. We'll do a few rounds more, and then we'll come together at center. All right, so from here, turn your right toes to face the back of the mat, and then walk your hands over to your right toes. Step your right leg back into plank. You should be facing the opposite direction. Take a breath in. Exhale, lower your chest all the way down. From here, untuck the toes, press down through the palms, inhale, lift the chest, the chin gaze. Exhale, lower. From here, flip over onto your backs. Bring your knees in towards the chest. Give yourself a great big squeeze. Ooh, great work today. We definitely kicked it up very quickly. I'm proud of you for sticking with it and making it to this part of the video. We'll close today with one final pose, and that's happy baby. So spread your knees wide, take your legs straight into the air. Arms come inside of the legs to catch the outsides of the feet. Drop your knees out to either side and just rock from side to side on your spine. This should feel really good for the glutes. The most important thing in this pose is that the bottoms of your feet are facing the ceiling and your knees are dropping down towards the mat. Stay here for as long as you like. One more breath. And then whenever you're ready, slowly release, extending the legs long onto the mat, dropping the arms off to either side. If there's any other poses or movements your body needs, feel free to add them in now. This is your practice, and you ultimately know exactly what your body needs. Begin to wake back up, wiggling the fingers, wiggling the toes. And once you're ready for movement, we'll meet together in a comfortable seat with hands at the heart. Thank you so much for joining me here today on your mat, for sharing this energy, and for sharing this practice. I hope that you feel good after this flow. I hope that you felt like you got a little bit of a workout in. I hope that you sweat a little bit, because I know I definitely did. So if you did enjoy this video, please give me a thumbs up, like this video, comment below, share it with a friend. Please share it with a friend. We're trying to spread this help to as many people as possible. So if this helped you, pass it to somebody else, and we can keep helping everybody around us. Thank you so much for being a part of this class and being a part of this show. Have a great one, and I'll see you next Thursday.